DJ Durrell.
The way we put this shit together, you know what I mean?
Welcome back to the channel. So the next video we're going to be reacting to today will be, which will be the next UFC event I'll be doing live reactions for, will be UFC 223, which will be Tony Ferguson versus Khabib, and then Thug Rose versus Joanna for her belt, because Thug Rose beat her. I still regret not ordering that dang event, bro. Thug Rose will also be on the card against Joanna, and Thug Rose will be defending her belt against her, and then we got Tony Ferguson versus Khabib for the belt. Which McGregor is on vacation still, waiting for that fight with Floyd Mayweather. So they have to fight for his belt, for the interim belt. So in this video, Joe Rogan will give his prediction for the Tony Ferguson Khabib fight. Let's hear what Joe Rogan really. Let's hear what Joe Rogan has to say about this fight. Who he predicts
some great cards to go over.
The Rocco Romero fight.
That's a great one. Romero, and then you got March 7th. Khabib against Tony Ferguson.
Holy shit.
Coming at you from all directions.
That's going to be insane.
In Brooklyn, New York. Are you doing a show that weekend in Brooklyn?
Yeah. Isn't it April? It's April, right?
It's going to be a crazy weekend, man. That's the same night as NXT New Orleans, which is going to be crazy. Going to be doing two reactions at the same dang time.
That's a crazy fight.
That is a horrible time.
That's a Rock'em Sock'em Robot fight.
Yep, it is.
That's a who the fuck knows fight.
Yep.
You know? That's one of those fights where you're like, whoa, that's going to be a crazy one.
Yeah.
Tony Ferguson's a bad motherfucker.
Uh-huh.
Khabib Nurmagomedov is...
Look at this card. Joanna against Thug Rose.
One of the scariest
guys. What's on this card that looks like that? Like, Anthony Pettis is on this freaking card.
Already. This is his first shot at the title. Just stop and think what would happen.
Pretty good looking
card.
If
Savage gets the title. That guy smashes people. What he did to Edson Barboza was supernatural.
Yep.
It's like he's not even the same thing.
Although you said something during that fight that said it all. There was one point in the fight that you said, look at the look.
In Edson's face.
Edson's face.
Yeah. He was scared as shit.
And I've had that look, and that's when you're getting chased by 18 people. He had a look that he didn't know.
He said he had no hope. He had no hope. Yeah. He went into like a survival situation, like when you see a deer that's getting attacked by a crocodile or something. They have this like survival thing where you're like, you're just trying to survive.
Yeah.
Obviously, deer
Khabib
is not the same.
Freaking crazy, bro.
That's a terrible analogy. Hold on, let me correct this. What I think is that Barboza had realized that, like, there's no way he's going to beat this guy on the ground. It's not even close. Like, I think.
And Khabib controlled the whole fight on the ground.
Probably thought
too.
He'd be able to stuff more takedowns and probably be able to get back off his feet because he was doing that with a lot of guys in camp. But once that guy gets a hold of you, there's an acceptance that certain fighters go through where they're locked down like, holy shit. Like, they're just drained from this animal mauling them, trying to retain their energy, trying to recharge their battery, trying to get back in it. And you got to realize, that guy, Edson Barboza, is one of the best fucking kickers ever.
Yeah.
Ever.
Yeah.
He's one of the best
kickers.
He'd
be my man Showtime.
Ever. That fucking guy is the fastest switch kick I've ever seen in my life. Outside of, like, professional Muay Thai, like Sanchai or Bukau or something like that, he's got a world-class left leg kick. I mean, woo! He's fast as fuck. He couldn't keep that guy off him.
Nope.
That was That's a how look scary that guy on his is. Face to me where he drilled for hours. He drilled takedown defense. He drilled everything there was.
I couldn't stop it.
But he never drilled this.
Yep. Couldn't do it.
Like, there was one point where he looked and it was like, wait a second. I've done everything I can. I even trained with the Giants, taking me down for a week.
Yeah.
Different
I
animal.
Never felt this.
Khabib's a different animal.
Different
I don't
animal.
Know how he keeps you down either. His control on it's, that side is fucking something that is.
There's certain guys that have a grappling skill that it's very hard to see when you look at it. Even if you're a skillful grappler yourself, you're looking at someone. Like, you're like, why is he able to do that to everybody? Like, what is he doing differently? Like, why is this one guy being able to do certain things that other people can't do? And there's a few of those guys out there. Where you watch him, you just go, Jesus. Like, what the fuck? And Khabib's the number one guy in that category because he's never been defeated. He's had one moment of adversity in the octagon. He got clipped by a punch from Michael Johnson. I can't think of a single round he's lost. Not off the top of my head, at least. I mean, he may have lost rounds on some judges' scorecards, but he's essentially mauled every motherfucker they put in front of him. He's an animal.
Yep.
So this guy versus Tony is phenomenal. phenomenal fight.
It's going to be a good fight,
because Tony is a savage, and Tony fights very well off of his back. He is a seriously dangerous guard. You can't sleep on him. He's durable as fuck. He can knock you out. He never gets tired. Mm. And he's as game as they come. And he's a fucking champ right now.
Joe Rogan already telling me to press the B button.
You know, when he beat Kevin Lee with a triangle, he beat a top guy like Kevin Lee with a fucking triangle. That's a big move. Tony's dangerous. Nasty Darce chokes.
Who you gonna pick, though, Joe? I know who you gonna pick.
He's great, but he wasn't ready for Tony, bro.
Kevin Lee was sick, too. Yeah, he had staff.
That staff infection. But no.
Unquestionably hurt him.
He wasn't. Tony is too high level. That was too... You could see in the second round.
Perhaps. I would like to see that fight again. You have to say that because that's how it went down.
That's how I saw it, yeah.
But I think that if you wanted to have them fight again, and Kevin Lee can go into that fight healthy... I think you'd see a very different fight. Okay. I don't think you would see Tony – I'm not saying that you would see Tony lose or Kevin win, but I would think you would see a Kevin Lee that could sustain his performance longer. I think being drained from staff is just right, – I've had it before. It's the worst. Your body – it's not the worst, but it's not good. Your body goes to a very weakened state. You are not the same thing. You just
never
not.
Had before, but one of my friends
had
it in high school.
If you're a real professional,
football,
you can go out there and do your job, and a lot of guys have. A lot of guys have fought and won. Luke Rockhold beat Chris Weidman on antibiotics. How about that?
Damn.
He was fighting off staff when he beat Chris fucking Weidman. That's how good Luke Rockhold is. Guys have done it, but that's not him at 100%. He wanted 70 or 80 or whatever the fuck it was, you know. There's no doubt about it. Staph infections and antibiotics both fuck you up. And Kevin Lee, I believe, opted to not take the antibiotics till after the fight. So he didn't want to weaken his system. But he's still weakened by the staph. Fuck. Fuck all that shit. Demetrius Johnson versus TJ Dillashaw. Super fight targeted for UFC 226 co-main event. Oh,
yes.
Shit.
Where's 226 at?
I don't know.
July, Vegas.
Ooh.
Stipe, DC fight.
Stipe, DC fight?
Shit.
That's a big card.
Let me tell you something, bro. They got some good cards coming up.
Yes, that's my initial reaction. Can we just fast forward to 226? Sorry, 223. Don't care. Yo, DC versus Stipe. And then the fight I've been dreaming to see, bro. TJ versus Mighty Mouse Johnson. Oh, just take my money, Dana White. Just take my money now. Oh, July. Oh, my goodness. All right. But anyways, back to 223. Pretty much, I can see Joe Rogan's going with Khabib. I can see he's going with Khabib. I'm going with Khabib to myself. I don't see Khabib versus Conor McGregor. That's another super fight I want to see. But dang, you going to do me like that, Joe Rogan? 226? Mighty Mouse and TJ and Stipe and freaking DC. Oh my god. Just fast forward to July. But anyways, guys, don't forget to like the video. Comment down below. Do you want to see this 226 probably going to be the best card this year? Comment down below. Don't forget to subscribe and then like the video. And follow all the social media links down below. Again, if whatever you want me to react to, you can request them there. And don't forget to follow the page just to see what I'm doing throughout the day on the social media pages. Thank you guys again for tuning in.
Yeah.
DJ Darrell.
Yeah. The way we put this shit together, you know what I mean?